Hi everyone, welcome to the first lecture of the Build Instagram to Master Swift 3. In this lecture, we'll briefly go over the main tool for building iOS apps, which is Xcode. It's an integrated development environment, or IDE for short, by Apple for building Apple apps. It can be downloaded for free from the Apple Store. So let's now go ahead to download it and install it. Alright, this is Xcode on the App Store. Because I already downloaded it and installed it, it shows open here. If you haven't, it'll show get or something like that. Now, once you've installed it, this is how it looks. When first opening up Xcode, you will notice a few options. Because we'll build a new project, let's choose Create a New Xcode Project from this menu. Well, then we can then choose several templates. For educational purposes, we'll use Single View Application option in this class. This is an almost blank template. That means we're going to build everything from scratch. Building from scratch is really the best way to understand how things work. All right, now hit next. Now, Xcode needs some information so that Apple can distinguish your app from others if you publish it. Enter your app name in the product name field. Don't hesitate to choose your own app name. You can then input your name or your company name in the organization name field. Apps can have identical names, so Apple needs to know whose apps they are. All right, next, fill out the organization identifier. The common practice is to use your company's website's domain name. If you don't have a company, you can put down your name in the suggested format. It's not really that strict. Don't worry if you don't own that domain name. Again, the main reason is to distinguish your own app from other apps that are out there, if you plan to publish it. Now, choose the program language you want to use. We use Swift 3 in this course. Object C is old, and we don't talk about it here. Next, we choose which iDevices we build this app for, iPhone, iPad, or both. The last three options don't matter in this class, so leave them unchecked. Okay, now hit next to choose where in your computer you want to save this project. It's entirely up to you to choose where your project lives. Here, we choose to save it on the desktop. All right, now let's see. Check this box if you want to use Git for version control. Git is a version control system which kind of helps you keep track of your progress, like what change you made or things like that. Don't worry if you don't know it. We don't use Git in this course. Click Create to create the project. All right, here's our project. So let's take a brief Xcode tour. On the left is the navigator area, which shows the project structure. On the top of this area are some tabs that provide different ways for navigating your project. You can access all the files associated with the project in this area. And the content of whatever you chose on the left will show up on the editor in the middle. This is where all the work is done, and all the magic happens. If you click on a file on the left, you will see the file content, which is its source code in this case. This is an almost blank project, so the placeholder stuff here doesn't do much. We need to write code to make sure that the app does what we want. But if you click the play button to run the project, it'll be running fine, because it's a functional project. You can see the running state here. It's running just fine, it just doesn't do anything just yet. Now, a simulator will pop up, and you can start using or testing the app in this simulator. Alright, here's the app. You will notice a blank screen, because again, we haven't built anything yet. It's kind of a default screen, or view controller to be precise, that Xcode provides us in this single view application. If we chose other templates instead of single view application, we would expect different templates, with some sorts of functioning views and buttons or things like that. Now, let's take a look at the files in this project. There are some default files of this project template, but we'll add more files along the way. First, you will notice a file called main storyboard. Clicking on this file will bring up the visual layout tool, also known as the interface builder. Let's zoom out a little bit so we can get a better view on this thing. Okay, good. You use it to lay out the user interface of the app. Again, this is a visual layout tool or interface builder. Basically, you use it to lay out the user interface of the app. you can code up the UI programmatically, but in this course, we use the storyboard, because it's familiar with many people. Now, on the right is the utility area, which contains details about the file chosen in the navigator. Here, you can set or modify properties of the file, or things like that. By the way, if your screen is too small and you don't want to work on all of the three areas, you can hide some of them. For example, to hide this utility area, you can click the rightmost button here, and click again to show it. Alright, there's two other buttons. The middle one hides and shows the debug area. We'll talk about this area later. The one on the left hides and shows the navigator area. We talked about this area already. Now, let's show the debug area. It kind of shows some information when the app runs, based on which we know if the app is running fine and how to fix it if it's not. Now, back to the utility area. You'll use utilities in this area a lot along the way, but it's not helpful to talk about them now. For now, if you click the third option in the sub area at the bottom, it'll show a kind of library, which contains things we use to build the app. They're like buttons, labels, text areas, images, and things like that. You can simply drag and drop them to the storyboard. Again, you'll get used to them when coding up the app. In short, there's four main areas we'll be working on. The navigator area, which contains project files. The editor area, which shows the file content. And the debug area for troubleshooting the project. That's a very brief Xcode tour. During the rest of the lecture, we'll talk about storyboards. In this course, we'll use something called storyboard references. Okay, storyboards are great for laying out the app UI visually. However, they were not easily manageable for large projects. Especially developers working in large teams were reluctant to use storyboards. If your team has several people, each is in charge of a feature, which has something to do with the storyboards. It's then very, very, very hard to collaborate. Of course, you can use multiple storyboards, but it's kind of hard to link them up. Fortunately, since Xcode 7, Apple introduced storyboard references, which makes storyboards much more manageable. Before Xcode 7, a workaround solution is to break a storyboard into smaller pieces and link them up by code. Since Xcode 7, you can do the same thing visually right in the interface builder. That means the storyboard references feature allows you to visually break a storyboard into multiple smaller pieces and visually link them up into a big, unified storyboard. You'll learn it during the course when building the app. For now, let's warm up a bit by learning how to create a storyboard. If we click the project on the navigator, we'll see that it has a main storyboard used as the main interface by default. Alright, let's clear that main interface field and delete the main storyboard. We'll make a new one and make it the main interface. But let's run the app to see what happens if we don't have a storyboard. Alright. Okay, nothing. We have nothing to display any content. So under the File menu, select New, then File, to create a new storyboard. Storyboard is under the User Interface category. You can name it whatever you want. Here we name it Start. Alright. Now drag it into the same folder with the default storyboard we deleted. Then choose the project on the navigator. We need to make it the main interface. In the top-down menu of Main Interface, we'll see the new storyboard showing up. Let's choose it as the main interface. Alright, great, nothing fancy here. We simply replace the default storyboard by a new one. We just want to know what's under the hood. Alright, let's run the app and see. If you notice, there's something in the deleted storyboard that the new one currently doesn't have. Alright. Yep, still nothing. When we deleted the default storyboard, we actually deleted the UI view controller that comes with it. And we need that to display content. So on the object library, let's drag a UI view controller into the storyboard. Note the error, we'll talk about it shortly. All right. For now, let's run the app and see. Okay. All right. All right. Still nothing, and still that error again. There's no entry point, so the system can't create a view controller object for us. So choose the UI view controller and go to its attribute inspector. Then make it the initial view controller. Now run the app and see. Our storyboard now has an entry point. All right. Fantastic. All right. Next time, we'll start building our login and sign up scenes. See you then.